करने के रास्ते पर ही ये नया टैक्स रेजिम आया है। सनसेट होगा कि नहीं होगा वो अभी मैं बोल नहीं सकती हूँ, वो रिव्यू करने के बाद ही हम एक डिसीजन लेंगे।
और ये एक आंकड़ा मैं आपको दे दूं कि इस बार पिछली बार जो हमने परिवर्तन किए थे नई टैक्स प्रणाली में, तो 70% लोग अभी तक जो 4 करोड़ के लगभग हमारे पास में रिटर्न प्राप्त हुए हैं पिछले वर्ष के, 70% ने इसको प्रेफर किया है बनिस्पत की पुरानी प्रणाली को। तो बड़ी तेजी से लोग नई प्रणाली की ओर आकर्षित हो रहे हैं और हमारा यही प्रयास रहेगा।
Yes.
More returns are coming in here.
Yes.
271. Hi, ma'am. This is Sumit Chaturvedi, ET Now. Ma'am, the corporate tax for foreign companies has been slashed to 35%. I want to understand the broad intent of this intention behind this decision and what kind of benefits to economy, increase in investment you are expecting.
You've, in your own question, answered it. We want more investment to come into this country. So that is why it has been brought down.
Just to add to that, there was a widened differential between foreign and domestic companies which arose after the tax cut in 2019. When the domestic rates were cut, the foreign rates were not cut. So there was a widening of the gap. With today's change, there is still a higher rate of tax for foreign companies, but it is not now disproportionately higher than domestic. And therefore, this is something where, according to the feedback received from industry, we expect more foreign companies to invest now that this regime is adjusted in this manner.
Good evening, ma'am. This is Pal Singh from Outlook Business. So you have earmarked a significant allocation towards rural infrastructure today. So how much of a boost to consumption and overall demand are we expecting here from this allocation?
It is difficult to quantify what would be the accretion to demand coming from, I mean, the obvious increase is whatever we have increased. But yes, would there be a multiplier? Probably yes. I think with the Awas Yojana Grameen and the Gram Sadak Yojana, these two do have a lot of multiplier effects as well. Traditionally, for capital expenditure, the multiplier has been calculated at somewhere around 2.5 to 3. In the Awas Yojana, it may be a little lower. But yes, there would be a substantial multiplier. I don't have a precise calculation.
But other than the Awas Yojana and Sadak Yojana, Gram Sadak Yojana, there's a major push towards the corridors. For instance, I mentioned in the context of Bihar, I mentioned in the context of Andhra, two corridors which are moving, one from Vishakhapatnam to Chennai, the other moving from Hyderabad to Bangalore, Buxar, Purnia, and so on, and building of the Gaya node in the Amritsar to Kolkata are all towards building infrastructure in the rural areas in order that we attract more investment and enable transit of goods in those huge corridors. All these are essentially going to the rural areas in a big way. And therefore, it is not just through PM Awas Yojana and Sadak Yojana, but major investments in strengthening the corridors, building nodes, and therefore also in improving the rural infrastructure is happening.
11.
Ma'am, I'm Maria Shakir from NDTV and NDTV Profit. Congratulations for creating history today by becoming the only finance minister for having presented 7 consecutive budgets. Ma'am, my question to you is about the first timer scheme, because as you said that employment perhaps sums up the essence of this budget. Would there be more blueprint coming out as to how this first timer scheme will be playing out and what will be the role of private sector?